What's up, America? Welcome to the hottest, bangingest, bestest radio show on the planet. Hold on, let's let this song ride for a second. Hold up. This shit ain't equate. Go. Let's go. All right, y'all. You are tuned into the best radio show on the planet. This is Queasy and Quake.
Quake and Queasy.
Quake and Queasy.
Queasy and Quake.
This is the Foxhole, Sirius 106, XM 149, and you are tuned into the Wednesday night shenanigans.
Yes, shenanigans. That's a big word that 50% of black men would not know.
I'm glad you said that, because tonight we're going to discuss why 50% of young black males are not graduating from high school.
That's going to be another take, but we got take one right now. We're going to talk about Ground Zero.
Oh, yeah, we got to talk about they trying to build a mosque down at Ground Zero, and people are going crazy.
Going crazy.
Going crazy.
Brock had to let them know they have a right to put the mosque anywhere they want.
Anywhere they want. So listen, America, hit us up at 877-2-106-106. That's 877-2-106-106. This Queasy and Quake.
Quake and Queasy.
We about to take a break. We call us up. We be right back. Let's go.
Yeah. Yo.
All right, y'all. Any day. Now, I was listening to the song. Play some, turn the song up, son. Negativity, give me name. You finna hit me. Yeah. Right here with my Henny. Say my chicks in plenty pay. Your boy checked, I'm blown and still repped the. But now I just wanna be left alone. They wish death in my flesh and my chromosomes. I don't know.
You don't know. Stop the track. Stop the music. Holler,
the yeah, you do gotta stop the music. Cause I don't know who the fuck that is.
What?
And you know, I know every rap song, man. Oh, that's Tech N9ne. 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 It's Tech N9ne, my man out of Kansas City. My man Tech N9ne. That's Tech N9ne. That's Tech N9ne.
Oh, first, the Fat Boys broke up. And you don't know a rap. Ooh, the Earl coming to an end.
Nah, that's Tech N9ne's new shit. Anyway, y'all, you are welcome back to the Foxhole Sirius 106. This is Queasy.
Quake.
And Quake.
And Queasy. Yes, in the building,
in
baby.
In the building, man. We having a good time. All right, y'all. Let's get right into it. Recently, there has been a controversy brewing all over the country. People are up in arms because there is a proposed mosque to be built two blocks from the World Trade Center Ground Zero site. Now, the whole thing came to light because a few of the family members of people who died said that this was an outrage and that, you know, they shouldn't be building a mosque anywhere near Ground Zero that is hallowed and sacred ground.
Yeah.
Barack had to come and put his two cents. He made a comment about it. He was speaking to some Muslim leaders, some Islamic leaders at a Ramadan ceremony this past Saturday night. And you can't be in front of Islamic speakers and not speak about the mosque being built down at Ground Zero. And he got, you know, God said he was in trouble for saying that these people had the right to build their mosque anywhere they wanted to. And whoopty, whoopty, whoop.
Yeah, he had to say something if he wanted to leave.
Because them niggas have chopped your head off in it.
They in shape.
We don't care if you's Muslim. We would have killed you too.
Yeah, in shape. But the kid, I don't understand the outrage though.
Well, here's the outrage. Here's what the argument is. And we want y'all to hit us up 877-2-106-106. The argument is that that is such a touchy subject.
Right.
Listen to me. Ground Zero. This is their argument. I don't agree with their argument, but their argument is that Ground Zero is such a touchy and hallowed place that building a mosque two blocks away showed bad taste and bad judgment on the people who wished to do that. Now, I want your take.
But I'm just saying, we was attacked by Al-Qaeda. We wasn't attacked by Islam.
Exactly.
So I don't understand between the two. I'm just saying, Timothy McVeigh blew up the
Oklahoma federal building.
Yes, and he was a Christian. There's still churches around there.
Matter of fact, they got crosses out in front.
Yeah, they got churches over there. I mean, I just don't understand it. I mean,
here's my take on it then. What it is the right wing That right wing. That
Tea
was
Party.
Those Sarah Palins, those Glenn Becks, those representative, who was it, Chuck Schumer, Chuck, whoever the fuck I seen on TV yesterday. Newt Gingrich.
Newt said,
He called him a Nazi.
Yeah, he said, would you want a Nazi player right here? Say, their church?
Yeah.
Their mosque?
That right wing has turned from a political party to a party of fear mongering.
Yeah.
Therefore, what they do is they try to instill some type of fear in their people that are following them to get them to act.
Right.
Therefore, you having all this outrage, whoop de whoop de whoop, and all this really doing is stirring up them gun toters and them rebel flag havers, them Tea Party motherfuckers that want Barack out of there. And so here's another way to have something to say. I think it's a bunch of bullshit, tell you the truth.
Okay, let's see what's up with Eric from Wisconsin. Eric. Eric. Eric, where you at?
Eric from Wisconsin. Give me some cheese.
Yeah, Green Bay.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now, brother.
All right, man. I feel like Earthquake Dude, man. They got the right to build that wherever they see fit. I mean, Christians have been killing in the name of God for hundreds of years. It wasn't all Muslims that blew up the building. I mean, you know what I mean? They, like you said, it was extremists. So,
right.
I mean, this country was built on the premises of religious freedom. You have the right to do certain things. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so,
exactly.
You can't group everybody together.
Thank you, brother.
All right.
Thank you, man.
Thank you very much.
What you're doing, you are giving the propaganda to the extremists because they see, look at that. Mm-hmm. They don't even want our march near there.
Right.
Yeah, see, one of the brothers went the wrong way. Now they're going to condemn all of us.
Exactly. And the thing is, the caller had a very valid point that America was founded on the belief and the institution of religious freedom, the freedom to practice your religion anywhere, anytime, any way you saw fit. So for Sarah Palin or anybody to say that these, now the people, the family members who had something to say, okay, I feel how you feeling. But them people who building that mosque ain't had nothing to do with Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda's something totally different.
Exactly.
And matter of fact, Sarah Palin and all the rest of them, where the fuck is Bin Laden at? Why the fuck y'all ain't seen bringing him up no more? Y'all want to say it's Barack. What about Bin Laden, bitch? The fuck about that? When you go into the motherfucking hills of Afghanistan and start looking for some motherfuckers, talking that bullshit. Fuck them, man. They made me mad, man. Talking to my president like that, man. He worked hard to become the first black president. That's that bullshit. Let's talk to Terrence.
Calm down.
I'm sorry. It's a sandpaper.
Yeah, sandpaper. I keep telling you, you're sandpaper.
You went off
and cussed everybody out.
My fault.
I'm an independent. I ain't a Democrat.
Me neither, but I'm saying.
Yeah.
Terrence in South Carolina. What's up, Terrence?
What's going on, Quaker? I just want to say, man, I love y'all show, man. I'm a truck driver, man. Y'all some funny ass dudes, man.
Thanks, man.
Hey, first off, I got two nephews that was in the Marine Corps, and one done 10 months in Iraq, and one done 10 months in the hills in Afghanistan. So,
okay.
I mean, they told me some stories that, you know, I could only imagine, you know. But, you know, I just want to say Barack Obama ain't got a hair on his nutsack if he let them dudes build that mosque, man. That's those people saying that, okay, we did this, and now we done struck here, so we're gonna build a monument to commemorate the job that we done.
One question. I just want to ask you a question. Who is that, those people? You said that's those people that's building the mosque. Who is those people?
Those Muslims.
So Muslims don't have a right to build their mosque in the United States of America.
They got a right to build their mosque anywhere they want to, but on the same token, it's not.
Either
it's
they
not
do
right.
or they don't. You can't be half pregnant. You either pregnant or you're not pregnant. If he got a right, then he can. If he don't, are you African American, bro? Hold up. I'm just asking you a question real quick. Are you black?
Yes, sir, I am.
Okay. How, and anyway, for a person of all us been persecuted for not having our rights, how can you not respect somebody else for having their rights? Even if you don't agree with it. If the taste ain't it, they have a right. And who are you or anybody else to tell them what the fuck they cannot do because somebody else that shared their religion did one of the worst crimes ever happened in the United States? You motherfuckers are crazy.
Thank you.
Y'all are crazy, bro. Oh,
let the brother talk. Let him talk.
Let me just say one thing. Can I say one thing?
Yeah, yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
I'm from the South, man. I was born and raised in South Carolina. And I'm going to tell you, like my mama always told me, the good got to suffer with the bad. When one of my siblings fucked up, we all got in trouble. Because when the rest of them seen that one sibling do what they done, it didn't stop them. So we all got it whooping.
Okay, so check this out then. Well, then check this out then, brother man. You from the South? What you say, South Carolina?
South Carolina, yes, sir.
All right, Terrence in South Carolina, y'all still waving. Don't y'all still got that flag with the rebel shit on it?
No, sir. We got that taken down.
Why did they get that taken down?
Nah, it's not taken
down. Why was that taken? Yeah, it was taken off their flag. Why was that taken off their flag?
It's not off their flag.
The Confederate flag. Yeah, I mean, they
exactly. Now, hold up. We protested the Confederate flag for a reason. Because the Confederate flag spit in the face of what we was going through in this country. Correct? He done got off the phone.
I told you.
I said correct.
All right, correct. So what I'm saying is this. You are trying to advocate. Matter of fact, you just trying to you trying to find the right way to say some wrong shit and you can't. Fuck off our phone. Bye, nigga. Fuck that. That's how we going today. Bye, nigga. Say no dumb shit like that to us.
Hey, I'm going to give it up to my man, Do Dirty, from Memphis.
What's up, Sasha? What's up?
What's that?
What up?
I want to say they could build a mosque any motherfucking where they want to. Because they say America is free. You know what I'm saying? So why are they trying to say what they cannot do? They need to be worried about getting all the motherfucking skinhead houses closed. They let them motherfuckers put them motherfucking nation. Then they talking about they don't want the church down there two blocks. They still got a motherfucking church right across the street from Oklahoma City.
How about that?
Memorial building. And then they want to talk about Obama. Stay the fuck off my motherfucking president. You know what I'm saying? He's trying to clean up some shit that motherfucking W. George Bush did, or G.W., whatever the fuck you want to call that. Sit back straight. He hasn't even been in the house for 2 years yet. He's pressuring these motherfuckers to keep your motherfucking houses that you lose or be due to the recession. So stay the fuck off his nuts.
Yes. Thank you, brother. I appreciate that. Do Dirty. And you keep doing dirty, my nigga.
All the time in Memphis.
All the time down
there. First 48 hours.
Yeah, this is crazy that people, I mean, I guess, I don't know. People must not understand what America stands for. The only reason we can be in this country and be able to say we want to do, the brother who called in, the only reason you get to do that is because we're a free society. You couldn't call up if we was in Pakistan and say, shit, them niggas will come to your house and chop your ass up.
Liberty is for everybody.
Yes.
Man. And you just because you don't agree with it. That's all I was saying.
Yeah, man. You said it right.
I'm just saying.
You said it right.
I wouldn't care what
I told them to get off my motherfucking phone. Let's go to Jerry in New Mexico. What's good?
This is Jerry. I'm a truck driver, too, and I'm from Alabama. And I think that was a very ignorant black man that called from South Carolina. First of all, the South, the same people, those conservatives, the Newt Gingrich and the Sarah Palins and so forth, they want to uphold the Confederate flag and say they have a right to fly it. They want to commemorate all of their Confederate dead, which were nothing more than treason against the United States of America. They want to put their Confederate flags on state houses, and they want to always remember these plantations and have all of these events and tourist stuff at these plantation houses where blacks were hung on the very trees in the yards of those plantation houses. All that's well and fine for them because that's part of their heritage. It's fair for those people to have that box because Muslims did not attack anyone on 9/11. That was Al-Qaeda, as you guys said earlier.
Man, you, I man. Love you.
Yes,
I love you. What's your name, man? Jerry?
My name is Jerry, and I'm a trucker. I'm from Alabama. Out here in New Mexico.
We about to do something new. It's called Jerry for President, goddammit.
And right now, you close down take one right now.
Yeah,
I'm
thank you very
you know.
Much.
Thank you. Yeah. Can't nobody follow that.
That was take
that was
one.
It. And we going to take a break. And what you going
to
do for
when us? We come back, man, we going to have a, we got a guest coming through. And we got some more shit to talk about. It's Cleazy and Quake.
Quake and Cleazy.
Sirius 106, bitch.
Sometimes.
Yes, indeed. This is Cleazy.
Quake and Cleazy. All day long.
Sirius 106, the foxhole. Hey, this is take two of our show.
Thanks
to all the callers. We moving on from the mosque. If you feeling a certain way about the mosques, hit us up on Facebook. Hit you at
Real Earthquake. Tweet.
Tweet him at The Real Earthquake. Hit me at and hit me at Joe Clair on Twitter as well.
Yeah.
J-O-E-C-L-A-I-R and leave comments there. We moving on to something else right
now.
Dr. Laura.
My girl. Host of Def Jam. Her and Mel Gibson.
They about to put out a new mixtape with Gucci. They hosting Waka Flocka new mixtape. Dr. Laura is ending her long-running radio show.
Called it quits.
Because of some racial slurs that came out during her show. We got a clip, Quake. Do you want to hear the clip?
Please do.
Let's hear the clip.
I was a little caught back by the N-word that you spewed out, I have to be honest with you. But my point is race relations.
Oh, then I guess you don't watch HBO or listen to any black comedians.
But that doesn't make it right. I mean, race is a big
my
thing.
My dear, the point I'm trying to make
to another level that's unacceptable.
Yeah, we got a black man as president, and we have more complaining about racism than ever. I mean, I think that's hilarious.
But I think, honestly, because there's more white people afraid of a black man taking over the nation.
They're afraid.
If you want to be honest about it.
Dear, they voted him in. Only 12% of the population's black. Whites voted him in.
It was the younger generation that did it. It wasn't the older white people who did it.
Okay. All right, chip on your shoulder. I can't do much about that. Yeah, I think you have too much sensitivity and not enough sense of humor. Well, it depends how it's said.
Is it okay to say that word? Is it ever okay to say that word?
It depends how it's said. Black guys talking to each other seem to think it's okay.
But you're not black. They're not black.
Oh, I see. So a word is restricted to race. Got it. Can't do much about that.
I can't believe someone like you is on the radio spewing out the nigger word, and I hope everybody
I didn't
heard it.
Spew out the nigger word.
Nigger. Okay.
Right. I said that's what you hear.
Heard it.
Yes, they did.
I hope everybody heard it. So what
they did, and I'll say it again. Nigger is what you hear on HB. Why don't you let me finish a sentence?
Okay.
Don't take things out of context. Don't double NAACP me. Leave them in context.
Means, and I know it came from a white person, and I know the white person made
it
bad.
Thank you very much.
Wow. Ooh. Dr. Laura is something else.
You sure it came out. When it said the right way, nigger, get off of my porch. Nigger, would you not be in my face?
Nigger, I am Dr. Laura.
Nigger, no, not here. I will not help you.
Nigger, I have a radio show.
Nigger, I say it.
Niggers. I hang out with black guys all the time, and they say nigger around me, and I'll say it anytime I want. I'm Dr. Laura. Nigger.
And they can say it, and I can't say it? We got a black president, and we never had so much racism just complaining.
Oh, nigger, shut up.
You won't be using that word at me, Joe. You will not. Dr. Lauren, please call me because I got to talk to you.
Yes, hit us up 1-877-2106-106. Anybody who knows Dr. Lauren, tell us to call. Tell her to call us, man. Real talk. Dr. Lauren need to smoke something for real.
She was in them. Oh, let me talk for a minute. You're not going to NAACP me.
Yeah, she heard you.
You're
not going to NAACP me, bitch. I can say nigger as much as I want.
Big Ben from Kentucky. How you doing?
What's up, Quakey, Cleazy, Quake?
What's good?
What's happening, player?
Man, I would have snatched that bitch's head off. She said it to me. I mean, here's the thing. She going to holler about is a word restricted. Would take your ass in the motherfucking velvet rose, bitch, and holler, nigga. You'll never make it up at that motherfucker. You know what I mean?
No shit. Take on the consequences that come along with you saying it then, motherfucker.
Right. And that's what she's hollering about. I can say whatever I want. This is America. Don't try to NAACP me. Bitch, take it to the bar and say it. See if you make it to the front door.
That's hilarious,
man. Thank you, Big Ben, boy.
I think she quit just for now. She done announced that since all the outrage and flashback and whatever you call it, what do you got?
She was just being honest, and it came out. She, you know how she felt, you know, and she let it out. Fuck
she
it.
Had fucked the nigga once, and he said,
"Fuck it, I said it, nigga."
What the fuck gonna do?
I fuck niggas all the time. Well, how could you be mad?
You're
at
only
me?
12% of the goddamn population. Shit. How do you think he became president if good white folks didn't?
Right, 88% of my dick comes from white guys. 12% comes from niggers. I can say niggers as much as I want. I'm Dr. Fucking Laura. That's hilarious. She quit her job. Anyway, she don't quit, but I think it's like a publicity stunt. She gonna try to show up on another network, some shit.
HBO hosting Death Jam. And we gonna fuck her up.
we gonna pelt that bitch like she Tila Tequila.
Oh, her and Don Imus going on tour.
Her, Don Imus, and Mel Gibson.
Yeah.
What a tour.
Yeah, that's the tour.
It's called Nappy Headed Hoes Blow Me, Niggers.
Selling out. Selling out. What's the name of it one more time?
Nappy Headed Hoe Blow Me, Niggers.
And don't you NAACP us.
Bitch. Hey, let's go to Troy in Indianapolis, Indiana. What's up, Troy?
Hey, what's going on with y'all?
What's good, man?
We hanging in here, brother.
Man, hell, I think they ought to grab this bitch by the hair and pull her ass and make her say nigga on the radio where I can hear that bitch holler.
So it won't be a joyous nigga. It'll be a nigga of
pain and greed.
Nigga, please.
Yeah, please quit.
Nigga, please.
Hell, stop. Hell. And the reason that bitch quit, cause see, we know where that motherfucker work at now, see? And got that, hell, we go out there, hell, there'd be a lot of niggas standing out there waiting on them.
Real talk. That nigga from Gary right there. That's a Gary, Indiana nigga right there, boys. We gonna wait on that bitch. That's real talk.
Nah, don't you NAACP me.
She said, don't NAACP me. I can say it as much as I want. Nigger, nigger, nigger. Yeah. She said it 3 times in a row. I ain't never heard it that boldly pronounced. Laura Bush don't even do that, Dr. Laura. Laura Bush was the head of the shit. She could have said as much as she wanted. She ain't even say it. Jenna Bush and them ain't even say it as much as you just said.
I like Jenna.
Yeah, Jenna Bush. You seen on the Today Show?
Oh, she on the Today Show?
Yeah, she done changed it up.
Oh, good white woman.
Yeah, good white woman.
Credit looking good. She looking good, ain't she?
Yeah, Jenna Bush is
helping
a keeper.
Helping all kind of kids.
Hollywood.
Hollywood Jeff in Alabama. Holler back at me.
What's up, bro?
Ain't nothing, player.
What's good?
See, man, you know, I got paralyzed in Iraq when I was 21. Man, I ain't know Miss Walker so much. When I heard that shit on the news, I wanted to run and find that bitch, man. Oh, everything, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, they love somebody to raise me. I was in the Army, so raising. I try not to pay the race card so much. But that's straight up motherfucking racist, man.
Hold up. Did you hear what this, bro? God bless you, brother, man.
God bless you.
What you've done for our country and the sacrifice you made. And this brother is paralyzed in Iraq. And he said nothing else he would rather do than get up and run up and go run and whoop this bitch ass.
That's hilarious.
That man got that.
That's classic.
That's it.
That's why this show is the best goddamn radio show on the planet.
That's it right
there. Because of all callers.
I'll call.
Wow, that's funny.
Man.
Let's go to Big D in Tennessee. What up, Big D?
Man, what's good, Clayton Cleason, man?
What it is?
Man, first of all, I want to say fuck Dr. Loyal, whatever you call that bitch. You know what I'm saying? She ain't no right to say no bullshit like that. That one is exclusive to all of us. All we can use this shit. You know what I'm saying?
She said
the worst word you can ever say. She put the
E-R
on the end
of
the shit.
Nigga, get off my porch. She said it like Paul Mooney taught her how to say it.
Yes, it did, didn't it?
Yes,
she
Paul.
She can lick your ass and lick my ass
second,
you feel me?
Wow. Say it again.
She can lick y'all ass first and lick my ass second.
Boy, you a bad motherfucker, Big D.
Give
it up for Big D in Tennessee. Thank you, brother. Well, as you can see, the people are outraged at Dr. Laura. She said, nigger, 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 I can say it as much as I want. Well, bitch, guess what? Niggas is looking for you. How you gonna sleep now? Cause I know how, I'm a nigga and I don't even want niggas looking for me. I don't sleep good when I know it's a nigga looking for me.
No, so that's right.
I don't
right.
know what you gonna do. The bitch gonna be on Xanax or something.
She gonna be looking, huh?
On Ambien.
Go ahead. What we got? EZ from Chicago.
Yeah.
Yo, what's up, players? What's up?
Ain't
what's
nothing, boy.
Man, y'all some crazy motherfuckers, man. Hey, check it out, man. Look, I'm the flip side, man. I didn't take offense to it. You know what I'm saying? Reason why I didn't take offense to it, because I'm going to tell you why that bitch kept saying nigga. Because she wants that nigga dick. That's what she wants. I'm telling you, man. That's all it is. Man, you know, I didn't take offense to it, man. I just look at it like this. You know what I'm saying? She wants to be with a black man. She loves a black man. And that, she had to get that shit out. She was a Benny. That's what she was doing. She was a Benny. Nigga, I want the dick. I want the dick, nigga.
Wow.
So she couldn't say all that shit on the radio. You know what I mean?
Hey,
I feel sorry for her. I feel sorry for her, bro.
Hey, really easy.
Easy. Yo, man.
Easy, man. You make us who we are, my nigga.
You are.
That's some good shit to say. You didn't take offense because you knew that this old white heifer was really doing a call for help.
Yeah.
Crying out.
Plantation day.
For some nigga dick.
Wanted to go to the bottom of the hill.
Yeah.
Hot in there. Boss wasn't getting it to her. So she said, I'm going down there at the bottom of the hill, pick some of that corn. Bitch, it's 2:30 in the morning.
Hey, remember Gator and them, father?
Yeah.
You couldn't help but try to get the sweet nectar of some young black buck.
They put her up on that scale. And that black man couldn't wait to get
some of the neck of that white man's woman. And you want some nigga nectar. You know why Dr. Lord went on there and said nigga so many times?
What was that?
Because a nigga fucked her credit up.
Barred the car, he never come back.
All that shit. Yeah. He got her, and she was on average. I can say nigga as many times as I want. Nigga, bring my car. Nigga. All right, let's go to Jay in Texas. What's up, Jay?
How y'all doing, man? Y'all got me rolling. I'm driving this truck. Let me hit somebody.
Don't hit
nobody. Don't do nothing, man.
Don't hit nobody.
Oh, man. First of all, Dr. Love, I don't care if she said nigga. She could have said nigga 25 times. I'm just as racist as she is. I hate black, Chinese, white, Mexican, all of them. I like black Mexican can't speak English. Why, you know, black people always pissing next to, I live in a house, a nice neighborhood. They pissing on the grass. I'm like, that damn nigga. Shit. White folks, I feel like, ma'am, oh, man, why you didn't pull my credit? My credit good. He's like, if I was white, I would have got it. You know,
right.
I just racist everybody. I hate all of them. But I'm cool with all of them. You know, yeah. But you know. I
feel you, bro.
I know it, brother. That's the way of the world.
I think he just killed that segment of our show. He closed it out.
He closed it out. He is true. That's close.
He said, fuck it. I don't like nobody.
I hate everybody individually.
He called us niggas back.
Yes.
I see what you call Mexicans, white people, white, and everybody. Why you don't only call niggas, nigga?
Because they niggas, he's saying.
Nigga. All right, y'all. When we come back,
take three. We're going to see about Brett Favre coming back.
Brett Favre.
Yeah.
He coming back?
Yeah, they went to go get him. Three of the team makers.
Fucking think he is Johnny Unitas?
This motherfucker, 552.
Yeah, he is. We be back. It's Cleazy and Quake.
Quake and Cleazy.
Foxhole, bitch.
All the time.
Yes, y'all. To the beat, y'all. Party having people guaranteed to be like having a ball. You are back. Tune into the greatest radio show on the planet.
Yes.
This is Cleazy and Quake.
Quaking Cleazy.
On the Foxhole Sirius 106.
XM 149.
Yes, indeed. Hit us up 877-2106-106. 877-2106-106. All right, y'all. That was LL's Going Back to Cali. Them 808 sounded kind of thin. That shit sounded like it came out of Nintendo as opposed to an Xbox.
Yes.
Yeah, that was the old 808 sound. Anyway, for the DJ on, we so fly, our DJ is in a whole nother motherfucking city. They in New York City. Next time, play Brenda's Got a Big Old Butt.
Oh, you like that?
Yeah, that was my record. I know I told y'all be true. Lisa's got a big old butt, so I'm leaving you.
See ya!
Oh, my God, if that doesn't sum up how a man feels.
Brenda, big old butt.
Yeah, I was at the mall. Chasing some tenders. And then I seen this big booty bitch named Brenda or whatever. All right, y'all, look.
It's time to go into some sports shit.
Okay. Take three.
I'm not a big sports guy, but my partner in crime knows everything about sports.
Yes.
From badminton to backgammon, this nigga got you covered. And today we're going to talk about Brett Favre.
Yes, Mr. Favre. 472 years old. Motherfucker played when they didn't have no helmets.
That nigga played football with rocks, is this what you say.
I'm telling you.
He started off football when it was foosball.
This white man refused to leave.
Refuses to go. And they paying him a beautiful sum to stay.
$20 million.
$20 million earthquake.
Three players went down there to pick his ass up and flew him back to Minnesota.
Wow.
Left practice. It was a black man that was playing quarterback. He never knew what happened.
So he out there in the heat practicing.
Practicing.
All of a sudden, here come Brett Favre across the field.
Three white dudes fly down there, pick him up in the private jet, bring him in. The brother said, oh, y'all didn't believe in me. Mr. Jackson, that's his name. Tavares Jackson.
So how should I feel about it, Earthquake?
He went to Alabama State.
Okay.
He was drafted in the second round.
Okay.
Childress, who's the coach of Minnesota, believed in him. But when the white glory man came in, riding in the white horse, tapped the brother on the shoulder and told him to sit his black ass down.
I don't know how I should feel about that, because Brett Favre is a football great.
Yeah, but see, you feel great because you still get your check.
Right.
Sit back, you get to learn from, you know, a Brett great Favre, Brett yeah. Favre. And the motherfucker can't stay there forever.
True indeed.
He 572.
Okay.
877-210-6-106. How long would this white man survive this season? I see this year, they're going to whoop his ass. I think they're going to blitz him so much that one ankle just going to walk up out that number.
And that's going to be that.
Oh, he's not going to make it this year.
He's not going to make it this year.
Oh, hell no.
So they wasting their 20 minutes.
No, they believe in him. They must have seen something in Tavares Jackson said, go get the white man. Y'all three just take the jet. This motherfucker's terrible.
Come here, Cuddy. Let me talk to you for a second. Take Jeff, Skip, and Steve. Walk out slowly. Don't let anyone notice you. And go and get the jet and bring Brett back.
Yes.
Money is no option.
What's the problem?
Do you see this nigga throwing these balls all over the place? Go and get Brett now.
William from Alabama, how you feeling, man?
Hey, man, y'all off the chain, dog. Look, I'm tired of this motherfucker here. Every year he boo-hoo crying, talking about he retiring. Take your intercept throwing ass on and shut the fuck up. I'm tired of his bullshit. Every year he end the season throwing an interception. He crying. I don't know if I'm going to play. Somebody break this motherfucker's leg and send him home.
Man,
That's the truth, brother. That's the truth. William telling the truth. Every year this motherfucker throw an interception, and they be waiting for him like he a fine bitch.
I just like the way William described it, because he described it as brother's will. This nigga is a Hall of Famer.
Yes.
One of the greatest quarterbacks of all
time.
Ain't
missed the game.
Guess what he called him?
No.
Man, tell this intercept throwing motherfucker get the fuck off the field.
He's a gunslinger. That same interception, man, throw for touchdown. Get San Francisco, man, 2 seconds left, pump fake, hit it to the back of the end zone. Made the SB player of the day, man.
How about
he's
that?
A bad boy. Dwayne from Virginia, what's happening?
What's good?
What's good with y'all, man? Y'all niggas is crazy, man.
We supposed to be.
Hey, I understand it. I can dig it. Yeah, man, this kid Brett Favre, man. I mean, you know, everybody loves the Brett Favre. You know, I respect Brett. But you don't have what's needed in order to win the big games, man. You know what I'm saying?
What they missing?
Yeah, last year when they played against whoever in the championship game, all he had to do was run the ball and get out of bounds. You see what I'm saying? Brett ain't got that hot no more. You know what I mean? So he throws an interception and his whole Cinderella season goes to shit. You see what I'm saying? So
yeah, Brett, I feel you.
Take it from a nigga who loves you, Brett. Go ahead and just say, you know what? I ain't got it no more. Just go ahead and bounce and wait.
Speaking for Brett, like, fuck you. They got $20 million in this motherfucker bank.
You love me. You really sound like a hater to me. It's what Brett sounded like. I agree with you, brother, but Brett don't.
$20 million. They gave him 13. Say you come on back, man. We put another 6 on top of it.
Damn.
Sad moment. Sentence and everything. Motherfucker came in. I'll tell you, he got it sweet, man. Don't practice a nut.
I wish they would do that in my comedy show.
I know that's right.
God damn. Speaking of which, I'll be at Laugh Out Loud at the Club Elite this weekend on Oxen here and on Brickley Road.
And I'll be at the Gibson Amphitheater in Los Angeles, California, Friday night.
Why you had to go
high? Hey, man, I'm just telling you where I'm at.
You know
man.
I'm on my way into a chicken wing dungeon. And you going to say, oh,
serving drinks out of mayonnaise jars.
Out of mayonnaise jars, nigga. Hot and steamy comedy club. And you on your way to the air-conditioned Gibson Amphitheater.
Yes.
Who you at the amphitheater with?
Kevin Hart, my boy Craig Robinson. There's a lot of us.
Oh, okay.
We about 10 deep.
Okay, well, I'm going to have to say mine again because it's just me.
But Twitter, man, real earthquake.
Me and Eddie Bryant this weekend at the Laugh Out Loud at Club Elite. Come get some chicken wings and drinks on your boy.
Because you got to laugh out because it's that small.
Yeah, man. Oh, it's... But this is one of my favorite places in the world to tell jokes, though, boy. I swear to goodness. Hey, let's go to Sean B. in Tennessee.
All day.
What's up, man? Y'all crazy. When y'all come to Nashville, man.
Oh, wait, Zanies. That's my joint right
man,
there.
Man, I just came from Nashville. Yeah. I did that little movie theater shit about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, I was at Zanies, man. That's the place to look out for. You're looking for comedy in your hometown. Zanies right there.
Zanies don't book me.
Well, we're going to talk to
catch y'all next time y'all come through. But, yeah, Brett Favre, man, you know, you can't hate on motherfucker. He sells tickets. You know, I think they're hurting. I think they're hurting the franchise at the end part of it because, you know, where are you building your future? Because, I mean, hell, this motherfucker get hurt this year, then what you got? But, fucking, I mean, he's a drama queen anyway. But, I mean, fucking, he's got a gun. You know, he's tested. If you got teammates that believe in him, fucking, you know, what can you say? But for $20 million, shit, I ride the fucking pine.
Yeah.
Huh.
Shit, so, I ride the pine for $20.
Yeah, but $20.
Yeah, if they said come to the games every week, we give you $20. I'm there, nigga. I'm there.
See, I can. Now, I need a little bit more than that.
I got a new baby.
I got three of them. $20 ain't gonna do it.
Oh, okay, you need
Ron 60. Ron from Ohio. What's happening, Ron?
Man, what's going on, Cleveland Quake?
What it is?
Yeah,
man. Check this out, man. These guys is hating on Brett Favre. If Brett was to say he wanted to go to any one of these niggas' teams, they would kick off their mother. They would kick a Tom Brady off their team just to get that Hall of Famer.
You
because that, he will get it. He gets it done. I'm a diehard Bears fan. I hate that motherfucker with a passion, but I respect that motherfucker's game.
Okay.
Thank you, brother. What's his name?
That was Ron.
Thank you, Ron. Cocaine is a hell of a drug. Stop, man. God damn, you crazy? They're gonna give up Tom Brady for Brett Favre. Hell no.
He went to the Jets and robbed them. Broke down like a Ford. Motherfuckers just say, I don't even want to play no more. It's my shoulder, my rotator cuff.
I got a Ford.
My
Ford
big
is
toe.
A good car. Broke down like a Fiat. How about that?
A Fiat, okay.
Yeah, we keep Ford. Ford might sponsor our show one day.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Ford. I'm so sorry.
Oh, this our girl. Is this D down in Alabama or is it D down in Louisiana we always talk to?
It's from Louisiana.
Okay, so this D in Alabama. What up, D?
What's happening, cub?
What's good?
Shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Man, these niggas, you know what I'm saying? Brett, I don't know what's wrong with that nigga that just called, man. I don't know. That nigga's crazy. What the hell that nigga drinking? Mad Dog 2020 or something?
Yeah.
Man, nobody gonna give up goddamn Tom Brady for no goddamn Brett Favre, his old ass. And he's sitting his old ass down, you know what I'm saying? I'm from the Gump, you know what I'm saying? That was DeVar's from, and he got drafted, you know what I'm saying? He come from the near high school. He got drafted by Arkansas, you know what I'm saying? But then they got that white boy that's in the league now playing receiver, and he went to Alabama State because he wasn't going to play. So,
okay.
I kind of feel bad for my boy. This shit keep happening to him, but... See, he just needs to keep his head up, you know what I'm saying? And just goddamn, just learn from him. The man is a Hall of Famer, you know what I'm saying? But they need to go and give my boy a chance, you feel me? And Brett Favre needs to go on retire his old lad and sit his ass down.
Nah, but see, the beautiful thing about sports is just go ahead and keep it. Soon it's going to be his turn because this old motherfucker is 972 years old. So eventually it's going to be Tavares' turn, and when it's time, motherfucker, I want all my money, motherfucker. Every coin.
How about that?
That's what you tell him.
Guess what I just envisioned? While Tavares sitting down there on the bench, Dr. Laura in his ear going, nigger, 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 nigger.
Stop, nigger. Joe. That's
why you're on the sideline, nigger. We bought Brett Favre back, nigger, 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 nigger.
Oh, Lord. No, he didn't take it there.
Dr. Lord just show up at the games and it's nigga.
Yeah. You're
never gonna be shit, nigga.
All right, give it up to my Las Vegas Frank from Las Vegas.
All right.
What is happening, my brothers?
What's ain't good, that, Frank? Man. Turn your radio down. Turn your radio down just a little bit, bro.
All right, now, all right. Check this out. Here we go. All about Brett Favre being nigga in the football league here now. You know the nigga can't go back to Wisconsin. Lawrence should be over there ruining his ass off. Send him to the Hall of Fame of niggas. Now, you know, he can come to the Hall of Fame. He can go and throw a game. He can sell tickets. But where's he going to go after he leaves Minnesota?
Thank you.
Ladies, please get your prenatal care.
Yes.
So that your children don't grow up and call up to the goddamn radio show.
Acting ignorant.
And say that shit he just said. That nigga sound like he had a bran muffin in his mouth while he was in it. And anyway, what are you going to do in Minnesota? Blackjack! This nigga's crazy. Waka flocka flame. This nigga crazy as a motherfucker calling up here, man. Don't call us no more. Look, man, we're going to take a break, man.
We need a break.
We about to take a break. We come back on break on take four. We're going to talk about where we at this weekend and all the other shit going on in comedy. This is Cleveland Quake.
Quake and Cleveland.
Foxhole, bitch.
Be nice, Joe.
All right, y'all.
Yes.
You know it's real shit going on here. This is Cleveland and Quake.
Quake and Cleveland.
Sirius 106.
Take four, man.
This is take four, y'all. And you know you listen to a real goddaggone radio show when you hear some KRS-One.
Yes.
Doing the damn show.
I love KRS. Big shout outs to you, bro.
Yeah, Chris the teacher forever and ever.
Ever.
All right, well, we were supposed to have a guest call in, but he said he was on the Amtrak train and he couldn't reach us. They got phones on the Amtrak. Nah, guys, that's that bullshit. He did that shit to me last time I was on the radio. God damn, I ain't even, he from my hometown, too.
Yes, he is.
Nigga from my hometown.
Yes, he is.
Rapper nigga.
Yeah.
He done got on.
Yeah.
Now, I was sitting in for another disc jockey named Donnie Simpson.
Tell me what happened.
Last summer.
Yeah.
And this nigga was supposed to call it. Oh, I'm on the train. I can't call you right now.
Yeah.
And then he just did the same shit.
Yeah.
That's that bullshit, man.
I see you upset, man.
Yeah, man, yeah. Well, I'm on my way to D.C. this weekend. Maybe I bump into the nigga.
Maybe so. Tell him maybe I said what's up.
I'm going to bump into him on the train.
Yeah. And tell him I said what's happening.
For sure. Hey, look, check this out. For all my people in D.C., man, y'all been keep, you know, people keep hitting me up on Facebook. When you coming to D.C.? When you coming to D.C.? I'll be in D.C. this Friday, this Saturday. Two shows Friday, two shows Saturday at the Laugh Out Loud out there on Brinkley Road, down the street from Rhodes Crawl.
Go ahead.
You know how it is. Up the street from Glass Manor.
Mm.
Oh, you know
Glass
what it is.
Glass Manor. That's what Rad Asson used to crank.
Yes, indeed.
Woo!
You know what it is.
Boy, in a moment.
Man, I'm taking my cameras with me, man. I think I might take my shows on Saturday night, bro.
I think you should.
Make me a new ghetto bootleg DVD.
Yeah, go
that's
on,
a
drop
wonderful
it.
Place to do that at.
We got
to
drop it.
I'm going to call it Chicken and Chicken.
And if you love our show, we'll be replaying it. Hey, you the big man. When they going to hear our show again if they didn't catch it today?
All weekend.
We are replayed. Now, Quake, you're at the...
At the Gibson Amphitheater.
Say that again.
At the Gibson
Amphitheater.
Yes.
That's
Friday night.
The big joint.
Yes.
The 6,000 seater.
Yes, I will be there.
That's going to be a hot motherfucking show, man.
Yes, we're going to have it. It's in Los Angeles, California, where I reside.
At the Universal City Walk.
Yes.
That's a bad motherfucker, boy.
Yes, it is.
I got booed in there one time.
Did you?
Oh, they gave it to me.
Oh,
nigga, I went in there in a suit.
Yeah.
I'm trying to tell jokes in a suit. Them niggas in the middle of hosting Rap City. This is when I was in the middle of my Rap City. I came in a suit with some goddamn diamond earring.
Yeah.
And was doing some highbrow comedy. Man, them Compton niggas, fuck off the stage, you trick ass. Soon as they said it came out the dark, all I could see was, all I felt was, why the fuck did I wear this suit?
Yeah.
Shit.
Yes.
I'm telling suit jokes. These niggas want jeans jokes. Shit. So I said, brother, I'm trying to do something. Education. I'm trying to do some smart shit. And a couple of people clapped, and then I went on the rest of my show. Out of the darkness, another motherfucker. Get your bitch ass off the stage! And then you heard, boo! Boo! It was, that was 1997.
Whoa.
That was the last time I got booed.
Yes.
I came back to the Gibson Amphitheater 2 years later, got a standing ovation. So that's how that goes.
Oh, man. That shit happened to me when I was at NC State. No, NC or what is North Carolina A&T.
Ooh.
Ah.
Whoa, them Aggies are giving to you.
Man, I'll never do another. And that was the last college motherfucking show I ever do. It's hard for me to perform for motherfuckers who ain't never had a job.
In Greensboro.
In Greensboro. Oh, they did it together. Ooh. I'm like, God damn.
Ooh, and them students boo the shit out.
Man, them motherfuckers are dance while they booing you and shit. I mean, I've never seen motherfuckers boo. It was like a wave of boos, nigga. It was just like it was coordinated. Some people like, go, Quake, do it. I was like, I'm not used to this.
Yeah.
Them motherfuckers threw me off.
Yeah, that boo is a bad motherfucker, boy.
Occupational hazard.
Occupational hazard. It come with the job, but you know, that was my last one. I ain't been booed since.
Me neither.
And it's 2010, so I'm talking 13 years since I had a boo or even a,
Yeah.
I don't even get them no more. I get, goddamn, you funny as a
motherfucker. Hey, I'll be in Dallas on the 27th at the Improv. Please check that out.
Okay.
At the end of the month, and Atlantic City on the 3rd. Come check me out. Philly on the 4th on Labor Day weekend. You got to come check me out there.
I'm going to Oakland and do this thing for Mark Curry on the 29th.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to D.C. for a minute. And then I'll be in Omaha, Nebraska on the 2nd.
Good market.
Omaha, Nebraska on the 2nd doing the Wrap It Up campaign with BET. You know, I still go talk to the kids about HIV and AIDS prevention.
And talk to our kids about graduating. 50% of black men not even graduating out of high school.
I got you on that. And then on the 5th, catch me in Jacksonville, Florida. Duval, I'm on my way, goddamn.
What's up, Duval?
Hey, y'all, check this out. This is Cleazy and Quake.
Quake and Cleazy.
Make sure y'all tune in next Wednesday and listen to us all weekend long.
On the Wrap Up, man, we'll have it on this weekend, and we love you now.
We love y'all. Hit us up on Twitter and Facebook, bitch.
You know it. At Real Earthquake.
At Joe Claire.